I'm joined by Flight Director Gene Kranz. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
Tell us what a flight director is and what you did during the Apollo missions.
Flight directors have probably got one of the simplest job descriptions in America. It's only one sentence long. It says the flight director may take any actions necessary for crew safety and mission success. During the course of mission, there is no higher authority. Mercury, we did not have a computer on board the spacecraft. So without the support of the tracking network and mission control, the crew had no idea where they were. They had basically a globe on board the spacecraft that was sort of like a coffee pot timer. And that was the mechanics of the system that we were using in the early days. When we put a computer on board the spacecraft, we had to tell the machines where they were and where we wanted them to go, and they were able to figure out how to get from point A to point B. So that was the nature of the computers that we had on board the spacecraft.
How important was teamwork in running these missions?
It was the essential commodity. It's like fuel for an engine. The breakdown in mission control covers all aspects of the trajectory, how you get there and how you get them back, and the machine that's going to do the getting there and getting back. So those were the three functions. I had a rectifier officer, I had a flight dynamics officer, and a guidance officer. But then somebody's got to worry about the spacecraft system. Key thing is, what you want the crew to do is the productive work in space. We managed the system. We managed all the communications. We handled the uplinks and the downlinks and switch TV and antennas and all these kinds of things. The crew is put in space to accomplish a set of objectives, and that does not include the long-term management of the flight systems.
How important was failure to the success of the Apollo missions?
Then Apollo 13 was interesting. Everybody would ask, are you going to get them back? And I got so fed up with the question, I started using the example. Suppose you're a heart patient and you're laying in the operating table and your chest is open. What do you want to see in the eyes of the doctor there? Failure is not an option. So I think this is the kind of relationship that we must have. Basically, I think that we're a heck of a great team, the crew and mission control.
If you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.